The ERG is a good tool rather in a medical optometric practice. It gives you an objective versus a subjective measurement of diabetic retinopathy. And if you look at studies, even retinal specialists disagree on the level of diabetic retinopathy. One says it's moderate, one says it's severe and moderately severe and whatever. So even retinal specialists, as well as optometrists and general ophthalmologists, can disagree on diabetic retinopathy levels. This gives you an objective measurement. It gives you a number. You can't argue with a number. And you can then use that number to follow over time. And I would argue that you'll see changes in that DR score before you actually notice huge changes in the retina. So that might start to slowly get worse, but the retina looks relatively the same. You can also use it to detect cellular stress, not observable on conventional OCT of retinal photos, meaning that you'll start to see some changes in these implicit times as the retina starts to become damaged before you see frank damage. It's the same with a visual field, right? Very often you'll see changes in the visual field before you actually see changes in the nerve structure. And you can use those changes to guide your treatment, whether that's an additional medication or whether that's better patient education or a better hemoglobin A1C score or referral over to our friendly retinal specialist. It helps make clinical decisions when conventional structure and function inflow conflicts and helps me feel more comfortable in my clinical decisions, right? I see a lot of patients with diabetes. I think that I do a pretty good job evaluating them for diabetic retinopathy, but there's nothing wrong with having that objective number to help me out even more. And, you know, I think about this a lot. I wouldn't follow my glaucoma patients with just structure, right? So why would you only use structure in patients with diabetic retinopathy? We know that structure and function do not always go hand in hand. One happens before the other sometimes. So now that we can check the functional integrity of our patients with diabetic retinopathy, why wouldn't we do that? Because by using both structure and function, we can get more intelligent and perhaps sooner referrals, especially those with functional change. And really, when you think about diabetic retinopathy treatment, we know that earlier referrals can lead to earlier treatment, which can lead to better visual outcomes. And that really is our goal with our patients with diabetic retinopathy, letting them live for as long as they possibly can with as good vision as they possibly can. So I think the RETeval can really help us take better care of our patients with diabetic retinopathy.